There is no doubt photos make your slides memorable. But do you want your presentations to be remembered for the wrong reasons? Today, I'll show you 5 embarrassing slide design mistakes that presenters make while using photos in their presentations. I'm Ramgopal from presentationprocess.com, the creator of Ramgopal's PowerPoint Mastery Program, the most comprehensive and creative PowerPoint training program available online. The link is in the description box below. The first mistake is using photos with copyright markings. When I was a young kid, I remember going to a small highway roadside restaurant called the Murugan Hotel. They used to serve water in a stainless steel glass like this. On the side of the glass, they used to have an etching which said, "Stolen from Murugan Hotel." So if anyone stole glasses from that hotel, they would be embarrassed to use those glasses at home because of that marking. Today, pretty much all stock photo sites use the same technique used by Murugan Hotel. They put a large semi-transparent copyright marking right on the photo, so anybody who uses the photo without paying for them would feel embarrassed. But apparently, these kind of markings don't seem to make any difference to some presenters, and they end up creating slides like these. If you've been making this mistake unknowingly, please stop it right now. You are embarrassing yourself and are stealing food from the plate of a poor photographer somewhere who has busted his backside to click that photo in the hope of selling it for some bucks. So just don't do this. So here are a list of 3 public domain photo sites that provide top quality photos for free that you can use in any of the personal or commercial projects. So use these photos instead of those photos with copyright markings. The second slide design mistake is stretching the photos out of proportion. This is a common mistake made by presenters who don't know how to work with photos in PowerPoint. So their slides look like this. Here is a quick lesson on how to resize photos in PowerPoint. Let's say you have a photo of this size and you want to stretch it till here. The amateurish way of going about the task is you select the photo and then stretch it laterally across like this. Naturally, the result looks ugly. A much better way to approach the same task is you zoom out a little bit and then you select the picture, hold the shift button down and click and drag from the corner till you are able to reach the distance you want, and then you can crop it till you are able to see the bottom edge of the slide area. Can you see here? As soon as you move your cursor over here, you are able to see the mark which says that this is where the slide ends. Now I have the photo positioned like this. If I want to readjust this, I can do so as well. I can select this once again, go to crop. This time I want to ensure that I crop till here. So I can select this and move it up like this. So I'm able to change the area which is cropped. Now when I click outside, you can see that the picture looks way better. You can learn a ton of such useful and practical PowerPoint tips in our Creative PowerPoint Slide Design and Animation course. The link is in the description box below. The third slide design mistake is using poor quality images on slides. This happens mainly due to the laziness of presenters. This is the usual process they follow. First, they type in the keyword, then go to images, and then look at the various image options available for that keyword. Then right-click on the first image they see and say copy image, and then they go back to their slide, right-click and paste it, and then they try to extend the image from corner to corner like this. And when you go to slideshow, you can see that the result really looks horrible. First of all, it is illegal to randomly copy images from Google and stick them on your slides. Second, it looks really ugly. Here is a better way. Find a Creative Commons photo on the topic of your presentation. You just need to type Creative Commons next to the keyword you're looking for. You will get a lot of photos you can use in your presentations by attributing the author. For example, I can go to the same keyword osteoporosis and write Creative Commons and hit enter and see what kind of results I get. I get a lot of these commons related images. I can go to the first one if I want to and then open the site. If I see that the image size is small, I can always click on the image and that opens up this large sized image. I can then click on this arrow to download the image and you can see that the resolution is fairly large. And to attribute the author, I can click on this icon here and I can just right click and copy the text and paste it on a separate slide at the end of my presentation like this to attribute the author. And when I paste the image that I got from Creative Commons, you can see the difference in the quality of the slide. The fourth slide design mistake is using photo background on content slides. I see this happen a lot in technical presentations. Take a look at this. If your objective is to show the picture, then that objective is not met because the text is blocking the view. On the other hand, if your objective is to show the text, then that objective is not met because the picture is obscuring the view of the text. Some presenters smartly use a washed out version of the photo as background. Let me ask you a question. Can you see anything about this image with this washout treatment? If you can't, then what on earth is that photo doing out there? Just delete it and see how your content breathes freely. I can understand if you want to use photo background on title slides, section headers, etc., where the font used is really large. But to use a photo background on a content slide is just wrong. The fifth and final mistake is using multiple photos on a slide without a proper organization. Once again, I see this a lot in technical presentations. The author really wants to share all that they know and have. So they stick images of all sizes and shapes and make their slide look like that fridge door, which has fridge magnets of all sizes and shapes and looks messy on the whole. Here is the solution. If possible, use one large image of good quality on your slide rather than using a dozen small photos. If you must use multiple photos, then organize your slide layout like this. By the way, do you want to learn some useful and quick PowerPoint tips and tricks that you can use in your next presentation? All you need to do is to click on the link here and start watching the video to pick up some useful PowerPoint tips that will impress your bosses and colleagues. Go ahead, click on the link and start watching the video right now.